So this is question number 22, and we are told the systolic blood pressure of 60 students attending a clinic were recorded as follows. So we have the blood pressure and number of patients. So those who are in between 95 and 104, there were 7. 105 to 114, there were 11. 115 to 124, there were 15. 125 to 134, there were 12. 135 to 144, there were 8. 145 to 154, there were 4. 155 to 164, there were 3. So we are told on the grid provided, draw an ogive that represents the above information, and you get 4 marks. So this is a grid that was provided, although it was not properly scanned, but you can just use any graph that you have. So part B, use a graph to estimate the interquartile range of the blood pressure. You get 3 marks. Determine the percentage of patients whose blood pressure exceed 150. So for us to be able to do this, we need to make a table which consists of the class. We have the frequency which is given. The frequency here is the number of patients. And we also include cumulative frequency. I'll show you how you get the cumulative frequency, and then the cumulative frequency percentage. So let's go to where we have this. So I'm going to make a table here, and this table will have 3 columns. So I think it should be 4. So we have like that. Can put the first row. This will be class. Then we have the frequency, we have cumulative frequency, and we have the percentage of cumulative frequency. So from our table which we have been given, we have 95 to 104. So 95 to 104, the frequency is 7. Then we have 105 to 114, 114, the frequency is 11. Then 115 to 124, 124, the frequency is 15. Then we have 125 to 134, the frequency given is 12. We can add this. Then 135 to 144. The frequency is 8 from the table given. 145 to 154. The frequency is 4. And finally, we have 155 to 164. The frequency is 3. So that is the information that we have been given from the table. So the other part will be, we'll be able to fill these other columns using this information. So cumulative frequency is when you add up the frequency. So we start with 7. 7 plus 11, that will give you 18. 18 plus 15, that will give you 33. 33 plus 12, that will give us 45. 45 plus 8, that will give us 53. Then plus 4, that is 57. Plus 3, that is 60. So remember, we have been told that the total number of the number of students as patients were 60. The percentage is you take this is for example, you take it is 7 divided by 60, the total number of patient, you multiply by 100. So this you get, it is 11.67%. Then here we have 18 divided by 60 times 100, that will give you 30.00. This will give you, use your calculator, 55.00. This will give you 75.00. Then we have 88.33, and then we have 95.00, and then we have 100. That's 100.00. So this is the information that we going to use to plot the ogif. So you come to your grid, so that's a starting point. Here we will have the cumulative frequency, and the total of cumulative frequency is 60. So we can say this 1 unit represent 1, so that is 10. This will give you 20, that is 30. Then we have 40, we have 50, we have 60. So that will be our cumulative frequency. Then here we are going to use a class boundary, and okay, we can start we can remove this 0 and say this is 94.5. the lower class boundary here is 94.5. We use the other one is here, which is 104.5. The other one will be able to get 114.5. We have this is 114, this is 114. We go to 124.5. Then we go to 134.5. We go to 144.5. And then we have 154.5, and we have 164.5. So those are the values that we are going to use on the scale. This is what we call lower class boundary, let's just say this is a class boundary. So we have that, let's remove that. Then you have this is 124.5. So these are the class boundary. So that is so we start from here. We start from this point here. In that class we have 7. So we will come and say, since 1 unit represent 1, that is where we have our 0.7. Then from there, remember we are using the cumulative frequency, we go to 18. 18, you will be able to identify that. The other one is 33. So 33, that's where we have our point. The other one is 45. So 45 is there. That's 45 here. We have 45. We go to 53. So this is where we have our 53. And then we have the next one is 57. 57 will be there, and the other one will be 60. So these are the points that we are going to join to come up with the cumulative frequency curve, or what we call the ogif. So using your free hand, you join those points. Let's correct that. You join this point and you come up with a graph. So it should be smooth, like the way we draw our quadratic curves. So that should be smooth like that. If you look at the shape of this one, it looks like a stretched S. Actually, we call it elongated S. So that is the ogif. This is the ogif. So once you draw that, then you should be able to answer the other question. Let's go to the question, and we have use a graph to estimate the interquartile range of the blood pressure. Since the total frequency or cumulative frequency is 60, it means the lower quarter is 15. You divide, remember the quarter divides the data into 4 equal parts. So if you divide 60, you divide by 4, you get it is 15. So the lower quarter is at 15, the upper quarter is at 45. So 15, you read the value that corresponds. You can use your ruler, press here, and read this value here. That value, which you call cumulative frequency 1, which is the 15th data, It is giving, you'll be able to see if you check here, 15 is here, you read that it is 112 plus or that is plus or minus 0.5. Then the upper quarter, that is Q3, which is at 45th data is here, so you read actually it is 134, it is exact 134.5. So the interquartile range, so you say range is equals to, you subtract, that is 134.5, you subtract 112, and that will give you 22.5. So that is the interquartile range. Looking at the other question, we are told to determine the percentage of patients whose blood pressure exceed 150. So 150 here, we say, look at, this is 150 around this point. So if you look at that point, there are five of them from here. This is 55 to 60. So it means there are five to calculate the out of 60, and you multiply by 100. That is to calculate the percentage of those patients that had their temperatures or blood pressure beyond 150. And when you compute this, you find that it is 8 1/3 or 8.33%. This is percent, this is percent. So that is a percentage of those patients that had their blood pressure above 150. So there you also get, let me check. There you also get 3 marks. So by doing that, so that's how you answer that question. You did this in Form 4 when you are doing statistics. So you should be able, and a very common question, so you should be able to answer such a question from what you learned in that topic.